In this video, I'm going to present the FADER test for gluteal tendinopathy. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Gluteal tendinopathy, which falls under the nowadays used umbrella term greater trochanteric pain syndrome or GTPS, is part of the differential diagnosis in patients with lateral hip pain. Grimaldi et al. From 2016 conducted a diagnostic accuracy study on different diagnostic tests that were contrasted to MRI findings indicative of gluteal tendinopathy. The FADER test, which refers to flexion, adduction, and external rotation, had a sensitivity of 30% and a specificity of 68.7%. When resisted isometric internal rotation was added, the sensitivity rose to 44% and specificity to 93.3%. A positive test can improve your confidence that gluteal tendinopathy is present, but a negative test will not alter your post-test probability much, which is why we give it a moderate clinical value. To conduct the test, the patient lies in supine. Then flex the hip to 90 degrees, adduct the hip, and add external rotation to end of range. Now ask the patient to perform isometric internal rotation against your resistance, which will increase both tensile and compressive forces on the tendon of the gluteus medius and minimus. A positive test is the reproduction of the patient's lateral hip pain in the region of the greater trochanter of at least 2 out of 10 on the NPRS. Alright, this was our video on the FADER test. We recommend that you continue by watching the video on greater trochanter palpation, as this was the test with the highest sensitivity in the trial by clicking on the left. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Please subscribe to our channel. It's free and it helps us out a lot. Check the links in the video description because I promise you, you won't regret it. And as usual, this was Andreas with Physiotutors. I'll see you in another video. Bye.